So when we start with the Wudang system, we need to learn the Qibengong. Qibengong translates in the Chinese to basic movement. The basic movement is very important for understanding Wudang martial arts. The basic movement starts with the basic posture. This is also why the first form we learn is called Qibenchun. Yes, we have an online student asking the question, what is the philosophy behind the Qibenchun form? The Qibenchun form is the basic foundation of our sequences that are the founding of the whole system of the Sanfengpai. So the Sanfengpai consists of 8 principles. You can check that on our website. Yes, these 8 principles are continuously after with the forms like Shuanggong, Longhua, Fuhu, all these principles. So the Sanfengpai, they decided on this Qibengong, so every student has a very easy time to convey these principles of these 8 foundings, these 8 pillars, yes, in our school. So this is very important. When we start with the movements and the Qibenchun, we first must learn the postures. So when we learn a form, we understand, okay, the first position, yeah, is ma bu. We stay ma bu. We know how we pronounce this posture. So coach only say, okay, you go ma bu. Everybody knows what ma bu is. If he says you do ma bu to the right side, right to his side, it means when you want to do the ma bu over here, you stay ma bu like here. Yeah? He want mabu to the left, you stay like this, yeah? You stay mabu here, this side. Yeah? So the direction of the posture and the posture itself is something we must remember. When we practice the Qibenchun consists of the 5 basic postures. There are some more postures, but in general it is the 5 basic postures like mabu, gombu, shubu, pubu, and xiebu. This we need to remember. If we have trouble with the basic posture, we can fix the problem by practicing the forms. This is why we practice the Qibenchun, because in the form we have all these 5 basic postures. Yes, in Ma Bu, how to transition to Gombu? Gombu, now you're straight. How to transition from Gombu to Pubu? Go down, now you're Pubu. Okay. How to transition to Shubu? Now you're in Shubu. Empty stance. How to transition to Xiebu? Now we are in Xiebu posture. So with all this, we only need to remember what is the name of the posture and how to execute the posture. If you can do this, you can ask yourself what I can practice to make this like resting posture. Xiebu translates to resting posture. So this we can rest, okay? It should be comfortable. How we do gombu? We need a hip training. Mabu, change. So I hope this explains the philosophy behind the Qibenchun. There is no more in-depth philosophy behind these postures, but it is the very founding of all other principles you want to learn in our school, yes? So if you want to achieve more in the other forms, Shuanggongquan, Fuhuquan, Longhuquan, Baxianquan, all these things, you know, you must learn the postures and then learn the Qibenchun form. So this is why today we focus on posture and Qibenchun, all right? Try to keep same high and dulibu, connect with elbow and stay calm. Go pubu, go same high, mabu, shubu, empty stance, leg is floating. Go up and stay calm and pubu again, okay? The more you try to relax, the easier the form will be, okay? If you go down like, oh, so hard, you know, no tension, just go pubu, easy, okay? We try again, everybody. So, how can we remember the movement, you know? Shishong will, all the Kung Fu Pada will say to you one time, yes, you do this. Shu Bu, then 45 degrees, then the Ma Bu, then Gong Bu, and so on. So for you to learn a movement that is new to you, you must remember what's the position. Okay, so we know we start Gong Bu, then Ma Bu. Then from Ma Bu, we go to Pu Bu and Shu Bu, then Du Li Bu. So we only need to repeat in our head. We repeat, Gong Bu, Ma Bu, Shu Bu, Du Li Bu, Pu Bu, Gong Bu. And this over and over again. When we learn the Bagua Zhang form, we also count in our head. We say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Because when we start learning the form, we don't know where is step 4 or where is step 5. You don't know. So we're learning the sequence. You do the movement, and inside your head, you repeat it. You repeat, Gong Bu, Ma Bu, Shu Bu, Du Li Bu, Pu Bu. It's also a reason why coach repeating the names of the forms over and over again. So you can remember how they are pronounced and then repeat them. And you identify the name with the posture. Okay? We try one more time. Hüpai. Gong Bu. Yi. Ma Bu. Shu Bu. Du Li Bu. Pu Bu. Gong Bu. Ma Bu. Shu Bu. Du Li Bu. Pu Bu. Gong Bu. Ma Bu. Shu Bu. Du Li Bu. Pu Bu. Gong Bu. And continue. Okay, so now is your time, okay? I don't say postures anymore. You try to repeat it. Yan Shu Lai, Bei, Zou. Yu Bei. Again, Qi Ben Chuan. 七边圈，预备。 This is Ma Bu. 一，二， change combo. Transmission good. 三，四，独立步， stand calm and look. 五， we go into 斜步 resting posture. 六。 And relax here, outer leg, step close. Qi, 45. Yes, very good. Combo. Ba, Du Li Bu. Stand calm. Look. Zhou, Xie Bu, punch. Shi, and relax, outer leg, step close. Breathe slowly. Yi, 45 punch here. Oh, Ma Bu. Si, Ma Bu. Si, Ma Bu. Yeah, don't step up when we change to Ma Bu. Lower, Ma Bu. Si, Pu Bu. Wu, Gong Bu. Liu. 七, 45 punch. 八, 马步. Stay low, 马步. Tiefer. Runter, 马步. 一, 马步. 二, 马步. 三, 瀑布. 六, 拱步. Shibu. Qi. Jump up and Mabu. Oh, Gombu. So, jump. Yes, kick and jump. Mabu. Lower Mabu. So, Schwangam Doi. Tornado kick. Shibu. So, Mabu forward. Punch. Yes. Ba. Combo, combo. Stay combo. Very good. So. And finish it. Yes. Zenti. Mabu. Elbow. Look here. Look elbow. Yes. And so, relax. Finish. Okay. Yes. Please remember the names of the postures so you have easy time with learning the Chibenchuan form.